What is up, y'all? Welcome to my first official actual YouTube video that I'm doing. I'm going to start off kind of my YouTube path with some Madden franchise. I just invested in Madden 23. Obviously, the season is now in the playoffs, so I'm just getting now into playing Madden. So everything you see is going to be my first time touching Madden, honestly, this year. I almost didn't buy it at all with how bad I felt the couple Maddens have been. But I'm also more of a franchise player. If you guys want to see something else or have any desire to see something different than just franchise, let me know. But I am going to run through and play an entire season or more, depending on the feedback of franchise as the Pittsburgh Steelers, which is my team. As you can see, Steelers helmet in the back, Watt jersey, James Conner. I'm from the same area that James Conner grew up. So I had a really cool, exciting experience with him being drafted as the Steelers. So again, this is my first time doing this. Let me know what you guys think. And let's get into it. All right, we're going to hop right into this preseason stuff. We're not going to play preseason games. I'm just not too concerned with that, but we will be playing the regular season games. It is on All Pro. If I find that it's too easy, I'll bump it up to All Madden, but All Madden again, it just makes the... In last Maddens that I've played, it doesn't make it more realistic or doesn't do anything like that. It just makes everyone on the other team better than they should be. And if they're already great, it makes them like next to impossible to deal with. So we're going to start off real quick by managing the depth chart to make sure that our team is lined up correctly. Kenny Pickett's a 72 overall. That's a little low, but I like it. Jalen Warren should definitely be number two. Benny Snell, in my opinion, shouldn't even. Oh, whatever. He's on the team. Makes sense. Fullback Derek Watt, Cameron. Connor Hayward, perfect. Wide receiver Deontay, no. George Pickens, number one. I guess that's fair. I'm going to put Steven Sims at number three. And Gunnar Olszewski. Miles Boykin doesn't play wide receiver very much. He's more of a gunner type guy. Freiermuth, Gentry Hayward, that's fine. Left tackle, good. Left guard, good. Center, Mason Cole, good. James Daniels, Chukwuma Okorafor. Left end, they got Larry Ogunjobi. That's great. Cameron Hayward. Sam Buttermilk's that low. Damn. Montrevious Adams, I like that. Over Tyson Alualu. Left out, obvious. Middle linebackers. I'm not gonna lie, Mark Robinson is gonna come up here in the fourth spot, and I'm probably gonna trade Devin Bush. Not gonna lie. In my version of this, cornerback, Levi Wallace, Cameron Sutton. I like that only because Levi will go up against faster receivers. James Pierre, they have as a 93 speed. I'll take that. Minka's the other corner. Free safety. Kazi Norwood, that's fine. Edmonds, Killebrew, Riley. That's fine. Killebrew's more special teams. Kicker, punter, obviously fine. Kick return. They have Gunner? No. Steven Sims. Sims is going to do all this stuff. No offense, Gunner. Sorry. You didn't. I realize you're better in Madden, but I'm going to try to go real life here in that aspect. Keep these guys. Third down back, Najee, absolutely. Power back, absolutely. Oh, get him. Get Chandler Moore. I don't even care if Benny Snell. Slot receiver. I want Steven Sims to be number one, George Pickens number two. Okay. Well, you know what? Hang on. Yeah, I like that. That's fine. They always mess this up. This needs to be Alex Highsmith. This needs to... Backup needs to be Jones. That's good. Rush defensive tackle. Needs to be Cam Hayward, followed by Ogunjobi, followed by Wormley, sub linebacker. That's fine. Honestly, I actually want Spillane in there instead of Devin Bush. Slot corner should be Arthur Maulette. practice squad. Okay, so here we go. We're going to go ahead and do the weekly stuff that we need to do. Injuries are on for practice because I think that's a normal thing. However, I don't think you can get injuries when you do half pads. And quite frankly, NFL doesn't really do, especially once the season starts, they don't do full pad practice normally. All right, guys. So set season goal. Here we go. Let's take a look at this. I'm just going to do make the playoffs. I want this to be realistic. I'm not one of those. I'm not going to play this out. You know, we're not going to quit games or anything like that. We're just going to play this stuff out. I just have to reiterate that for some reason. Choose draft class. I'm going to download from Madden Share just because, and I'm not going to look these through. I don't think I can look at them before I choose them anyways, but I am going to download one of the real ones for 2023 draft class, just because I think it'd be fun to see some real names pop up as the season is already over, technically for Pittsburgh. It will be cool to see some of the names pop up. Opening day keys. We're going to speak to the media. It's opening day this week and a fresh start for every team around the league, and you'll be facing the Bengals. What's the key to victory? Stifling defense. It all starts with defense. We plan on making their offense uncomfortable and keeping them off the scoreboard as much as possible. Do this, right? Yeah. You mentioned making their offense uncomfortable. Where does that start? It starts with... For the Bengals, it starts with disrupting the pass. Does it? Stuffing the run. That's definitely a Bengals answer. A Ravens answer. Might be different for the Bengals. Okay. Allowing less than 75 yards rushing. Oof. QB1. Yeah, we're doing this differently. We're starting with Kenny Pickett. That's tough for rookies. There's no expectations. No expectations. We just want him playing a continuing to improve. If he lights it up, that's great. If he struggles, we can always use it as a teaching lesson. I don't know if Tomlin would say that per se, but he'd say something like it. Game plan for an elite quarterback. Facing a quarterback like Joe Burrow always presents an immense challenge for any defense looking to stop him. What style of play will give him the most trouble? Unrelenting pressure. It all starts with pressure. If he has too much time to throw, we'll get torched like everybody else. But if you can apply pressure and make him uncomfortable, it gives you the best chance to slow him down. Facts. Especially with defense. 2+ sacks? Okay. Entire defense will help. Oh, let's go. Let's get into it. First full game of Madden 23, also for everyone to know that. I'm not using the special passing abilities.
No holds barred between AFC North rivals. It's the Steelers and the Bengals on EA Sports. EA Sports coverage of the National Football League takes us to the banks of the Ohio River at Paycor Stadium in the Queen City of Cincinnati. Today, no waiting around. We jump right into an AFC North battle in week one between the Pittsburgh Steelers and the Cincinnati Bengals. Alongside Charles Davis up in the booth, I'm Brandon Gauden. Very pleased to be with you for another season of NFL football. Mm. And Charles, we are no stranger to rivalry games between Cincinnati and Pittsburgh. What is different is that the roles have kind of been reversed. Cincinnati comes in as the division favorites following last year's Super Bowl appearance. The Steelers no more Big Ben, and they're now viewed as likely underdogs.
And we've known that the roles have been reversed since last season and the entire offseason. Yet still hearing you say it, it still has to sink in. And I know the Bengals fans, they're very happy to see those roles reversed because they had dropped 11 straight to Pittsburgh prior to their recent resurgence.
11 straight.
Great test for both of these teams to start off this season.
Here we go, Buffalo crushed LA.
Coming off of the Super Bowl.
Week one. Oh, this is going out the end zone, yeah.
Yep. Started now, the kicker Chris Boswell, and we are underway from Cincinnati.
It's time. Keep an eye on Joey B. He expects to bring a Super Bowl title to Cincinnati in the near future.
The run on first
step or not? Many times you just don't take any step. Just get your feet moving. Get your body.
Get up there, Levi Wallace. Oh, dang. Okay. Okay. That's what we're gonna have to go up against.
It's going to be the last one we see.
I think you're exactly right about that.
And this is caught inside the five.
Dang.
He'll take this into the end zone for Bengal TD.
Okay.
T. Higgins, 37 yards. And the Bengals are on the board here first in the season opener.
You know what? It's how it was in the beginning of this year. So that is what it is. Steven Sims.
Taken in at the three.
Oh, if I could have got the edge there. Oh, I should have let it come in. Dang it, that's okay. All right, we're going to go ahead and run it on first down because that's what Pittsburgh likes to freaking do all the time. No, I don't want that. Oh, okay. I like this. I like this a lot, actually.
First carry for the second year man. It's Najee.
We'll take that. Big game for Najee on first down.
Nine before being brought down. Second and right at a yard. The last run got nine. That leaves him with second and a yard. Throwing there.
Damn.
On first and ten, it's Pickett. Toward the sideline, and look at that catch.
We take that. That's going to be a constant this year, baby.
On second down, this is Harris. He'll get about four here.
Take it. Third and three. Run a little play action. Look for Gentry or Freiermuth here.
Creating space in order to run plays. A toss play will help accomplish that because now you're pushing a defense to chase you all the way to the edges and to the sideline. That's a nice run.
Oh, no shot. They want us to go for it. Oh.
And that's normal NFL football. They're going to throw on third and short, but you got to hit it, don't you? Yeah, in the first quarter, like you said, to set the tone, can't connect.
Damn, didn't get it. Time to bring some pressure here.
And Charles, nothing like squaring off with a division opponent.
Sack for TJ Watt, baby. Let's go.
Now on third and long, they'll look to throw. And a double coverage, and it's intercepted.
Jackson
with a pick. And the Steelers come up first and 10.
All right, Najee.
At their own 43. They'll start to drive with
Yikes.
Harris.
Okay. Oh, this is my play. This is a touchdown to George Pickens, potentially.
Start out. That leads to a second and 11.
You are one? No, he's okay.
Looking to throw, Pickett.
Oh, that's a sack.
And he'll be taken down by
Damn. I'm still going to try to get the first down, but we're going
to
do it. See what happens.
But you're exactly right. Definitely going the wrong direction for the offensive guys.
Setting up the screen, Harris. And the Bengals will take over here first and 10.
I'm going to blitz him again. Close this up. I'm going to be splaying, not blitz. I'm going to play back just in case.
Try to shake off the interception from the last drive. He'll look to throw. And they have the football and will set up shop at the 33-yard line.
We'll take that.
And right back out there after the turnover. Now they've got to work towards getting another couple of stops and forcing them into at least a long
Swagger.
Field goal situation.
And he'll head out of bounds inside the 10. Mark him down. Now Pickett.
They didn't read it that time.
They'll try and set up the screen. It's complete. And in for the Steelers touchdown.
Let's go.
Najee Harris, a 9-yard touchdown.
We take that, baby.
And the Steelers are within an extra point of tying up this ball game.
Into the first. Not a bad first quarter. This is also my first time playing this Madden, so. We'll take that. It's coming up here if they decide to not run it.
Here's Burrow setting up to throw it. And for the third time, they try a lateral on the return, and now the ball's loose. And I think
okay, so I may need to turn up QB accuracy and stuff like that, or try all Madden. This is having three picks on Joe Burrow is a little ridiculous in week one in the first half.
Just getting sprayed, selected in the first round, getting the start here as we mentioned in week one. It's got to be quite a whirlwind for a young quarterback.
Absolutely, because going in the first round, people
are going
to be the starter right away. But many teams want you to get your feet wet first. You know,
put us up by three.
Hang out behind a veteran starter. In this
we'll
case,
take that.
Get sent it right to the top roll.
Burrow on third down. Got a man. It's Chase. He completes
here we go,
it.
Here we go.
If you blitz and have him in man coverage, you're going to him. Even if he has an elite defender on him, because he usually knows where the ball is before the defender does.
Oops.
And they'll get him down on
it's
the
kind of my area.
Side of midfield.
Plenty of room to run after
Jack's
the catch
midfield.
To pick up really nice yardage.
Throwing now, Burrow on first down.
Minka.
Time here in this half, it's intercepted. Picked up by Minka Fitzpatrick. And he brings this one back. It's a pick six. Steeler touchdown. Burrow will throw. Looking deep downfield.
He caught that. Dang, man. Time.
They become just as critical to the passing attack as a lot of receivers, tight ends, because their ability to make people miss in the open field can really generate big plays for an offense.
Out of this, something about whittling it to a one-score game at half that might provide.
Oh, bad time to blitz. He could have made it. I don't like that Edmonds is man-to-man with this tight end. He's all the way here. Dang it.
Touchdown Bengals. It's Tyler Boyd taking over.
Run a quick screenplay just to see if we can get some yards.
Yeah, with a little under a minute to go, still time to try to put a drive together to add to their lead.
Blitz.
So choose. He gets it complete to Harris.
Out of bounds. Save the timeout.
First and 10. Here's Pickett.
Why did you not run across? That is such. That is such a Deontay Johnson thing. So. That is such a Deontay Johnson
the
thing.
Game proceeds. He's going to go back out.
And his pass is intercepted for the fourth. You're about ready for their next drive. And with good starting field position and three timeouts as well in their pocket, no reason not. And this is caught at the 20. A big go in the first.
I'm looking
half
for Freiermuth here quick. So if the middle linebacker doesn't come back.
The 20 now for first and 10. That is caught inside the five. And the Steelers are going to be.
Here we go.
They'll try to run with Harris.
And Najee, touchdown.
Touchdown, Pittsburgh. Najee Harris, already his second touchdown here in this opening weekend. And the Steelers will extend their reach
halftime
here on opening weekend. As we'll send you down to Orlando,
let's check out the halftime report.
Jonathan Coachman for our EA Sports halftime report. Coach.
All right, Brandon, thanks very much. And welcome back to football, everybody. We've got a full slate of 16 games here to start the new season. So let's take our first trip around the NFL. We'll begin up at Bank of America Stadium in Uptown Charlotte. And the Panthers are out in front as they play the second quarter. DJ Moore, a touchdown reception. From there, we head over to Hotlanta to check out the Falcons at home at Mercedes-Benz Stadium. And for the moment, they trail the visiting Saints in that one. Alvin Kamara with two touchdowns thus far. Finally, we finish at MetLife Stadium to see what's going on with the Jets. And at this point, they trail the visiting Baltimore Ravens. Devin Duvernay, a touchdown reception. Time now for a check of the next-gen stats in that first half for the Steelers. And even though they've got the big cushion, I would imagine they'd like to see a little more out of their passing game. Pretty pedestrian numbers through two quarters of play. Meanwhile, for the Bengals, they were even better throwing the football. Lots of open receivers to choose from, and you can bet that'll continue to be
good through the air and really all around an outstanding offensive performance.
Absolutely.
Pickett lost it.
Woo-wee.
Free. We could
pace.
Get that, those two guys out in front.
Sustained runs, taking their time, and making it work.
Najee's not much of a spinner, but oh well. I probably should have just ran him over.
Now a first down carry for Harris. The solid stiff arm. It's a pickup of 12.
Got it.
From the gun, here's Pickett. Pickens on the slant. And he's got another first down as the tackle's going to be
holding
at the Bengals' 12-yard line.
Holding.
Dan Moore.
Hell no!
he's trying to.
So if you have to hold occasionally, do so because they don't catch all of them. This time they did.
Now a throw downfield is taken in by his running back. And he's got another first down. Pickett will look to throw it here. Got his man.
Steven Sims, baby.
Steven Sims.
Lane.
Push it and try and get back to where you were to start.
Watching Joe Mixon.
Second and 10 now. Burrow. Throw right side. Pulled in by Higgins.
Oh.
ball comes out, but this will get out of bounds, so possession will stay the same. Against man than zone, or
better against man, because now you're running away from someone and you're not running.
Touchdown.
Jeez.
Jamar Chase, a 16-yard touchdown. And the Bengals are,
trying. It sucks because all pro is fairly not bad. It's easy to win the games, but the computer doesn't always play trash, except the 4 or 5 picks, whatever it is now.
He'll look to throw it
quickly, and neither did he. They got to him just in time, and now that forced him to make a decision with his fourth down call.
Let's go, Derek Watt, just like in real life, always clutch on those fourth down conversions. Johnson on this one. Not gonna lie. Oh, Johnson, look.
Got his man complete over the middle. That's Johnson. And that'll be good for 8 yards to the front.
There we go. 31-21.
Three quarters here on NFL kickoff.
Running on him like crazy.
Watching the NFL on EA Sports.
I'm doing it again, Derek Watt.
This late in the game, Charles, I think you maybe seriously have to think about going for it.
Especially where they are in terms of field position, because this is almost...
Didn't get it. Damn it! That's okay.
First down, close it out.
First down, here's Burrow. And now here is another interception. Picked off by Arthur Maulet.
It can make
Sims is going. Brian is right there. Okay. I might look for Pickens on this one.
Second and nine.
Pickett. Oh, I'm sacked.
And he's gonna go down. They sack him back.
Tier potentially Pickens. I don't want to throw it to Don Johnson. I'm not gonna lie. But we'll see what happens.
A throw there, but that's gonna wind up incomplete.
47-yard field goal.
Receiver, but they just couldn't connect, and that will send them back to the drawing board.
Got it.
Boswell's kick is good, and that will extend their lead even further. So that maybe not a knockout blow, but I suppose certainly every little bit helps.
On Watt. Come on, Watt.
Just 1 for 3 thus far. They're up against a 3rd-and-1 situation. Open man, it's complete to Higgins. Throwing again on second down. Burrow. Again, that's Hurst.
They didn't get the kind of yards they had hoped for. That's going to bring up third down.
11 MP. 11
they
MP.
Give to Mixon to try to pick it up. And he appears to be about 2 feet short.
Let's go.
3rd-and-3. Leaves him with a 4th-and-1. Well, look at the clock. You're down 2 scores.
Didn't matter. So they've been preparing for that on their play sheet the entire time.
11 Thomas.
They'll try and run with Mixon. Mixon hit, and all the ball is out. And it's picked up by
the number of turnovers this game are wild. Game.
Burrow. And the Steelers.
Was that Highsmith? Was that Highsmith? Who was it?
11 minus.
Here we go. It's Burrow on 4th down.
Let's go!
They go down to a knee, and the new campaign off to envision the
I'm gonna kick this.
Season, kneeling it down. Defense can't stop the clock. This one's a winner.
Just so it doesn't look like we failed in the red zone, I'm gonna kick this.
Practice stuff really only happens like one time a week. The best teams I know, they practice starting back in OTAs. They want them to visualize winning a game and how great that feels, and they got it done in this.
I like it.
A knee gets them to 1-0. Well, this was not just the open
not a bad game one. Like I said, I think we need to up the difficulty here. It was a little too easy in my opinion, especially with the defensive interceptions. But moving forward, we'll see what all Madden looks like next week and go from there for sure.
The season and you open within the division, you knew the motivation was going to be there on both sidelines. One just executed better.
We'll take a look at these game stats before we end.
So for Pittsburgh, hey,
6 interceptions.
You get it on the road. You can't ask for much more than that to start the year. And they'll return home next week to take on the New England Patriots. Meanwhile, for Cincinnati.
All right, so player stats. Let's take a look at this. Passing. Kenny Pickett, not bad. 13 of 20. 2 touchdowns, the 1 interception. 167 yards. Joe Burrow put up 377 on us. That's not great, but 6 interceptions, whatever. Rushing, again, let's look at the Steelers only. Najee Harris with the 22 carries for 81 yards. His average went way down from what it was in the first half. It went down like 1.2 yards per carry. But again, 81 yards for him is not bad. One touchdown. Wait, did they actually give? No, Derek Watt had the two. It's not bad. Najee Harris with the led receiving receptions, 4 for 39.
3 for 23. George Pickens, 3 for 82. Let's go.
Deontay, 1 for 8, whatever. Steven Sims, 1 for 13. Gentry, 1 for 2. Getting the ball around there. Blocking, Chooks had a pancake, but allowed 3 sacks. Oh. Defensively, Edmonds with the tackles. Highsmith and Watt were the 2 sacks. That's fantastic. Interceptions, William Jackson had 2. Mallette one. Minka with the pick 6. Edmonds 1. And Levi Wallace had 1. Kicking, 3 of 3. 4 of 4. Phenomenal. Punting, 41 average. Or 43 average, excuse me. Kick return, 24.7. Not bad. We'll take those stats. Let's see how these game goals went. I was really impressed by our ability to stop the run this week. I think we felt the pressure to step up, and it led to great things. I think you're right, TJ. Exactly. If we can sustain that kind of success, this kind of success for this entire year, this defense is going to be scary. You're not wrong. But all Madden next week might change that. You were able to have success against Joe Burrow and get the win this week. What went into making that happen? I think you saw what went into making that happen.
Joe Burrow's a special player, but we had an excellent game plan that the team executed. Really proud of how our defense played.
So am I. Our defense gained 2,500 XP. Dang. TJ Watt will have his X Factor active for the entire next game. Oh, Sack City. Sorry, Mac Jones. All right, y'all. That's going to end it for this one. So there we are. Week 1's in the books. I apologize if this was a little long or short. I don't know. Let me know what you guys think of the feedback on this first video. Let me know in the comments. Again, I appreciate you guys coming and watching. So, and also linked down below will be my Twitch, where I may be using this to stream this franchise live if that's something you guys desire. But also linked will be my actual Steelers podcast, Steelers by the Lake. A buddy of mine from back in Pennsylvania and I do Steelers podcast weekly right now since we're in the off season. But give it a listen, and I appreciate that. So again, thanks for stopping by, guys. I'll see you on the next one.